Everyone, I'm Jeremy from class 483 at Dongwan A Primary School. Today, I am going to introduce about Dongkap Cultural Tourist Village for you. It's next to the Highway 4C, about 25 kilometers from Dongwan Center, or about 120 kilometers from Hazang City. It's located in Sung La Commune, Dongwan District, where many Hmong people and some ethnic minority groups such as Hoa, Lolo, S Central, Four Centers, is at the beautiful oasis inside the beautiful Sung La Valley. In the village has a lot of public flower, a very beautiful flower. Now we are going to visit Dongkap Village to know more about an old house. The cultural tourist village of Dongkap is always vibrant with flower in all four seasons. At this time, public flower are in full bloom, and the place where I am standing is the famous public flower field of the Dongwan Stone Plateau. You will be able to admire the vast field of blooming public flower, showcasing the brilliant pink hue across a stunning valley. For those who love photography, this will be an ideal spot for you. When you visit in spring, you will witness the blooming of apricot and white bloom flowers lining the roads, creating an incredibly picturesque scene. Along with the shimmery beauty of the wonderful yellow mustard flowers that will leave a lasting impression on you. Visit Dongkap to explore the ancient house with hundreds of years of history, characterized by the distinctive stonework in the architecture of the Hmong people, along with the long-standing cultural belief, will surely provide visitors with a comprehensive view of Dongkap in particular and the Dongwan Stone Plateau in general. Go deeper into the village, we will gain a better understanding of the architecture of the house as well as the daily life of the Hmong people living here. See an old house of Mr. Mua Sua Pao, a Hmong man. He built this house in 1947. With director Ngo Quang Hải to as the filming location for the movie, The Story of Pao, adapted from the work The Sound of the Mao Harp Behind the Stone Fence by writer Do Bích Thủy, the film won several important awards at the 25th Golden Kite Festival of the Vietnamese Cinema Association. As a result, people know more about Mr. Mua Sua Pao's house and affectionately call it Pao's house. The story of Pao's life represents the resilient and enduring spirit of the Hmong woman in the alley. This ancient house is very typical of the traditional architecture of the Hmong people. The entire house is a closet, self-contained structure consisting of four sections connected around the square yard in the center. It is surrounded by a stone wall. The columns of the house were made from red pine or jackfruit wood, and the base of the columns were intricately carved in the shape of poppy flowers, and the floors laid with wooden plank. They are skillful craftsmen. The house had a shelter cellar during the war. It used to shelter. In addition, there is a stone stele above the shelter. Outside the gate, there is a wooden dry mill, and opposite it is a side building that includes a storage room and a kitchen. Upon entering, you will feel a sense of familiarity and the charm of antiquity. At present, it is owned by his grandson, Mua Sinh Gia. My presentation ends here. I hope you will visit Lungkup Village one day soon. I look forward to seeing you at the Lungkup Cultural Tourist Village. Thanks for listening and watching.